Welcome to my lady.
Nancy Drew, I presume. I'm Joanna Riggs. Welcome to Beach Hill. I was just checking the lock on this display case. This is one of the museum's most treasured pieces, a carving of King Pakal.
Who is King Pakal?
Pakal assumed the throne at age 12. Can you imagine? That was 615 AD. He ruled for 68 years at the height of the Maya civilization.
Is that jade?
Yes, the Maya loved jade and used it for many of their carvings. There isn't another piece like this in the world, and it's priceless, which means I practically had to sell my own grandmother to get it.
How did the museum acquire it?
Leave it to Taylor Sinclair. He's a wizard when it comes to these deals. You'll meet him later. Now then, Nancy, you're coming on board at a critical time for Beach Hill. An exhibit of this caliber is not kid stuff. Franklin Rose assures me you're a real trooper, and I hope he's right because I'm not here to babysit. I don't care who your father is.
If there's one thing I've learned from my father, it's the value of hard work. Just tell me where to start.
There's a list of tasks for you in the lab. Once you've knocked those off, we'll regroup.
Where's the rest of the staff around here?
We've had to make some, budget cutbacks, so we'll be relying heavily on our volunteer staff. Namely, you. Besides Henrik and me, the only people who will be around to pester you are Taylor Sinclair, my ace art dealer, and Alejandro Del Rio, attaché to the Mexican consulate and executive thorn in my side.
Tell me more about the exhibit.
In addition to our permanent collection, we're borrowing rare pieces from museums and private collectors around the world. Soon we'll be sitting on the most fabulous collection of Maya artifacts ever assembled in one place. And now that we've scored the monolith, too, Beach Hill será numero uno.
Was the monolith excavated in Mexico?
Yes, a hot young team of archaeologists, Americans and Mexicans both, dug it out of a cave near Palenque. Every curator from here to Siberia was trying to get a hold of it, but I'm the one who closed the deal.
Did Beach Hill buy it?
No. We could barely afford the price of the loan, for one thing. And besides, nowadays it's not even legal to sell artifacts out of the country of their origin.
What exactly is a monolith, anyway?
It's a massive pillar of stone, nearly 1,500 years old, with Maya glyphs carved into it. We've installed it in the garden. Wait until you see it.
Could you explain what a glyph is?
A glyph, as in hieroglyphic, is a picture that represents a word or an idea. Henrik is the human encyclopedia on the subject.
How do you translate them?
Henrik can help you with that.
Who's Henrik?
Henrik Vanderhoen, world-renowned expert in Maya hieroglyphics. He's the latest addition to the Beach Hill Brain Trust. I told him I don't even want to see his pointy Vander head till he's got a translation on that monolith.
Any last advice before I get down to business?
Semper ubi sabubi.
Topeka Commission for the Arts. How cultured. Topeka Commission for the Arts. That's the organization Prudence Rutherford works for.
Nancy Drew, or should I say, Detective Drew. I'm Sinclair.
Who told you I was a detective?
I was at a meeting with the BOD recently, and I caught wind of your appointment and your credentials. Very impressive, if I do say so myself.
Well, I'm not on a case right now, that's for sure. I'm the new deputy curator, remember?
So, how's this for a specimen? Ever seen $1 million worth of rock before?
Do diamonds count?
Ouch. Well, they did say you were sharp. Seriously, though, thank goodness you're here. I'm afraid the museum may be in terrible jeopardy.
Oh, no. Is there something I can do?
Joanna told me to butt out, but I'm so fond of Beech Hill, I just hate to see it fall prey to scoundrels.
What scoundrels?
It's a sensitive subject. Meet me in my office later, and I'll explain everything then.
Where's your office?
707 Bing Cherry Boulevard. I've got to go. Enjoy your first day at Beech Hill!
I need to find another piece.
Silvio's Curatorial Bonanza.
I'd like to place an order, please.
Have you ordered from us before?
Yes, I think so. We have an account number.
Okay, good. That saves me a lot of paperwork. What's the account number?
BH119K.
BH119K? Beech Hill? Are you serious?
That's right. I'm the new deputy curator, Nancy Drew.
Well, whoop-dee-doo, it's Nancy Drew. But Silvio's Curatorial Bonanza no longer does business with Beech Hill. I've sent all 6 of the outstanding invoices to a collection agency. And you jokers won't get another packing peanut out of Silvio Jr. ever. Do not call here again.
There, that looks like it's in order. There, now I can start putting this together. Done. looks right.
How may I help you?
Buenos dias. Me llamo Nancy Drew. I have some paperwork for you regarding the loan of the Palenque Monolith to Beach Hill.
So, you're Joanna Riggs' newest pirate in training. How does it feel to join the ranks with the modern-day conquistadors?
Conquistadors?
You had better brush up on your history, young lady. When the Spanish explorers invaded Mexico, they became known as the conquistadors, or conquerors. They robbed the indigenous peoples of their wealth, not just their gold, but their artwork, their sacred objects. Anything they did not steal, they burned to the ground.
Do you blame Joanna and modern-day art collectors for something that happened long before they were born?
There is more. In the 19th century, archaeologists discovered the ruins of ancient civilizations predating even the Aztecs. Many of the dig sites were robbed, and the stolen artifacts were sold off to art museums and collectors around the world. Today, finally, it is illegal among most civilized nations to remove an artifact from its native country. But sadly, there are thousands of precious antiquities with highly questionable provenance floating around the Western world.
I see. Well, I should probably get going. Here are the changes to the loan agreement for the monolith. I just need your signature, please.
Thank you. I have some business with Joanna at the museum later, so I will return the contract to her then, after I have looked it over.
Are you sure? I don't mind waiting.
You may consider your mission accomplished.
Well, okay then.
Goodbye.
It's about time. Oh, my fears are like maggots infesting my poor old carcass. Want a cookie? They're from Oaxaca.
No, thank you. You said Beach Hill is in jeopardy. I need to know why.
The art world is being ransacked, Nancy. Prudence Rutherford, a major patron of the arts, had her fire ruby necklace stolen from her villa in Topeka. 2 weeks later, a whole display case full of rare Maya artifacts was heisted from a museum in New Mexico.
What does this have to do with Beach Hill?
I'm just telling you, this community, our friends and colleagues, my people, are being systematically trounced by thugs! Who's to say Beach Hill won't be next? You've got to do something!
Does Joanna share your concerns?
I've urged Joanna to approach the board about making some security upgrades, but she just keeps saying that the timing isn't right to ask for money.
I understand your concern, but what can I do to help?
We need your eagle eyes. We need your bat ears. We need you to sniff out the stink of trouble!
I'll do my best, but it sounds like what you really need is a new breed of police dog.
Don't play modest mouse with me.
Modest mouse? Most people call me Nosy Parker. But anyway, tell me something about the art business. Is that a contemporary painting?
You bet your socks it is. Would you believe I dug it up in my backyard?
Good thing you're not trying to make a living as a comedian. So, what about the painting?
How about that rubber shark? The artist's name is Poppy Dada. She's a teenager in South Dakota. The art world is going bananas over her stuff. I'll unload that one for some serious dinero.
I'd better get going.
See you around.
Good thing Franklin gave me the museum key.
You must be Nancy, the new deputy curator. I'm Henrik Vanderhoen.
Pleased to meet you. What are you working on?
Just some light housekeeping.
Huh? Housekeeping?
Keeping artifacts clean is an important aspect of preserving them. Anyway, what can I do for you?
See you around, Henrik.
Bye.
too been hit. Sit tight, Nancy. The police are on their way.
I should talk to Joanna before I touch anything.
Someone has cooked up my worst nightmare and served it to me on a plate.
I'd like to have a look at the crime scene myself. Did the police turn up any clues?
The police took some samples for the crime lab, but they couldn't promise any overnight results. So if you want to put your little magnifying glass up to the scene, it's fine with me.
I've got work to do.
Carpe diem! Need something?
Have you seen Henrik? I found a piece of paper inside the Pakal display case. It had some glyphs on it and a print of a red hand. I'm hoping he can give me a translation.
What am I, fish food? Henrik's not the only one around here who can read a glyph, you know.
Okay, great. Did you happen to see the thief's message?
The police showed me the note. It said, "The magician suffers yellow death," whatever that means. Apparently, the thief just couldn't come up with the glyphs for "the curator suffers flaming purple disgrace."
I'm curious about the red handprint the thief left. Does it have any significance in Maya culture?
Afraid I can't help you there. What I want to know is what the hand was printed with. It's obviously not finger paint. Why don't you do a little analysis on it in the lab?
I've got work to do.
See you around.
Okay, I've got a graph of the chemical used for the handprint. Now I've got to match it. That's it! S stands for sulfur. According to the... So the handprint was made from mercury and sulfur.
Come in. Need something?
I did the chemical analysis you suggested. That red hand was printed with a compound containing mercury and sulfur. Does that mean anything to you?
Sure, cinnabar. The Maya would rub it into their most important carvings to add definition to the artist's lines.
Does the museum keep cinnabar around?
We use cinnabar here at the museum the same way the Maya did, to keep things as authentic as possible. Henrik orders those kinds of supplies, but we've been out of stock for quite a while. The last I heard, there was some kind of holdup with the distributor.
I've got work to do.
Semper ubi sabubi. Henrik!
Amnesia? Wow. Henrik must have taken a real nosedive off that pyramid.
Do you think he just fell, Nancy? Or was he pushed? Sounds like you need to find out about hospital visiting hours.
Yeah, but you'd better get the lowdown from Joanna first.
George is right. She is your supervisor, after all.
First the Pakal carving is stolen, and now my star glyph man bumps his head and forgets his own name? What's next, Nancy? Del Rio pulls the plug on the monolith, the board clams up on my funding, my mother posts my old prom pictures on the internet?
We do seem to be on shaky footing, don't we?
What I need from you right now is action, not commentary, Nancy. Will you follow up with the hospital and see if there's anything we can do to get Henrik's marbles back?
I'll call right away.
You can also pick up Henrik's mail if he gets any. Keep the lab in order and... Just try to help me keep the entire museum from going up in smoke.
I've got work to do.
Semper ubi sabubi.
I should put in my temple key card. It's locked.
jail.
Nancy, hi. It's Franklin Rose. I'm calling because it's just... this theft is very bad news for the museum. You can't imagine the limb we went out on to acquire that Pakal carving. It's been one of the museum's main attractions. I don't want to take you away from your internship, but if you can do a little investigating, well, I think I speak for the whole board when I say we'd be very grateful. Give me a call when you have a chance. And Nancy, thanks.
This message is for Nancy Drew. Hi, Nancy. This is Nurse Bluefoot calling from Eleanor Roosevelt Memorial Hospital in regards to Henrik Vanderhune. I believe you're a colleague of his? Since Mr. Vanderhune was admitted, he has repeated your name several times in states of semi-consciousness. As we've been unable to contact any of his family members, we're hoping you might be willing to act as Henrik's support person as he begins the difficult process of restoring his memory. Please call me as soon as possible to discuss this. My direct line is 202-555-4000. Thank you.
To replay messages, press 0. Press 9 for an outside line. You have...
This is Nurse Bluefoot.
I'm calling in regard to a recently admitted patient, Henrik Vanderhune.
Patient information is confidential. Are you a family member?
No, I'm a colleague of Henrik's. Nancy Drew is my name.
Nancy Drew? Oh, thank goodness. Oh, I'm so relieved. We've been unable to locate any family members. And we do like amnesia patients to have at least one personal support person when they begin reality orientation.
What's reality orientation?
Well, reality orientation is a kind of treatment that helps a patient get reacquainted with the facts and circumstances of his or her life. Henrik has not actually lost his memory. It's just that his brain is injured in such a way that he can't access the place where the memories are stored.
I see. So we need to help him find the trail of crumbs. Is that it?
Exactly. First, we do repetitive memory exercises to help Henrik relearn the basic facts, like his name and address, the name of his parakeet, if he has one, the date, and so on. Second, we try to stimulate Henrik's sensory memories in order to help trigger or find the way back to his cognitive memories.
Where do I come in?
You can't help Henrik remember his childhood, but you can probably help him remember his work, and who knows where that will take him. All roads lead to Rome, as they say. One great tool is the Reality Orientation Board. This is a place to post information and pictures for the patient to look at over a period of time. You may want to bring in images or photos to place on the board. Things from the museum, perhaps.
Is Henrik awake right now?
Not at the moment. We're keeping him under close observation.
I see. Well, when are visiting hours?
Visiting hours are 10 to 4 every day. If the patient is not engaged in treatment and if he seems stable.
Stable how?
Just remember, Henrik's brain has been knocked around like a peanut in its shell. He may have attention difficulties, headaches, anxiety. Sometimes he may seem giddy, too. We need to keep these conditions in check. Don't push him too hard, or he may have some kind of meltdown.
Thanks for the warning, Nurse Bluefoot.
Be well.
You have no voice.
Boswell, Jackson, and Rose, how may I direct your call?
This is Nancy Drew, calling for Franklin Rose, please.
Just a minute, please.
Nancy, hello. Do you have any news?
Not really, but something tells me this case is going to get complicated.
Oh, Nancy, you zero in on a case like a heat-seeking missile, don't you? I feel so much better knowing you're going to follow up on every lead. I'll help in any way I can.
Thanks, Mr. Rose.
That's what I'm here for.
It needs a card. It's locked. I wonder if Henrik would remember the answer. I'd better go back.
You look familiar. Is it time for my snack?
Hi, Henrik. I'm Nancy. We met at Beech Hill before your head injury.
Beech Hill?
Beech Hill is a museum here in Washington, D.C. The curator's name is Joanna Riggs. You were working there, and that's where your accident happened. Do you remember anything about the accident?
Joanna Riggs, is that the woman who called to pick my brain for an access code?
What access code would that be?
Where in my poor banged up head would I be keeping access codes?
I don't even remember my own birthday.
So if you're here to squeeze me for details, you're wasting your time.
Actually, Nurse Bluefoot thinks with regular visits, I may be able to help you get your memory back more quickly.
How, pray tell, do you intend to do that?
I'll visit, we'll talk. Sometimes I'll bring you pictures.
Pictures? Well, isn't this nice?
Think of it this way. You just got back from a fabulous trip. Only you can't remember the places you went. So you decide to look through postcards to see which ones you recognize.
Fine, I'll do it.
Okay, here we go. These symbols mean the magician suffers yellow death.
Your translator is sloppy. I should know. I am the author of the original work.
The author? What are you talking about?
That first glyph is the fool, not the magician. Furthermore, any decent epigrapher knows those glyphs refer to the infamous plague of oozing hives. A fitting curse for a fool, don't you think? I rather like it.
If you wrote this note, then you must have stolen the carving of King Pakal. Did you?
I don't remember.
I'm investigating the theft of the Pakal carving. Please, Henrik, try to remember something.
Who in the world is Pakal? Oh, my head. Oh, the pressure. I can't take any more today, Nancy.
Okay, it's time for some memory therapy. Nancy, could you come back tomorrow?
It's a fiasco, just as I feared. Oh, I'm sick, sick, sick about the whole thing.
I see you've spoken with Joanna.
I was in the museum when it happened.
Have you spoken to the police?
I told them everything I know. I mean, I coughed up my brains right there on the table.
Did you hear? The thief left a glyph message with a red handprint on it.
That awful red hand was left on Prudence Rutherford's jewelry box in Topeka.
and on the display case in the museum in New Mexico. What's the chance they're not connected?
Do you know Prudence Rutherford personally?
Oh, we saw each other at functions now and then. Poor Prudence. She adored that necklace.
I need a photo of the Pakal carving. Do you have one?
Joanna took the official print for her insurance claim, but I have a couple extras. Here you go. Keep up the good work.
Well, look who it is.
Ready to do some memory work, Henrik? I brought you a picture. This will help you to remember.
That face. He's as familiar as my own feet.
Do you know his name?
Pakal! Nancy, this is the stolen carving, isn't it? And I'm the one who took it. I must have. But why? Oh, Pakal! What could I have meant by this?
Think, Henrik. Where's the carving now?
I can't remember.
Easy, Henrik. The answers are in your head. You just need to find them.
It's still in the museum.
Are you sure, Henrik? Did you plan to sell the Pakal on the black market?
To protect him. I had to protect him. Oh, Pakal! Something is going on at that museum, a devious plot. I was the only one who could stand in the way.
Where in the museum did you hide the Pakal?
Forgive me, Nancy, but when I woke up in this hospital bed, I didn't even know my own name. Perhaps the only thing I can offer you is this key. It was found in one of my pockets when I was brought in.
Do you know what lock it belongs to?
I haven't a clue. Take the key now, Nancy. Find out what it opens and return to me, please, with some answers.
You can count on me, Henrik.
In the meantime, I'll sit with my friend Pakal and see if he will tell me anything new. You must keep this to yourself for now. It's your only hope of getting to the bottom of this.
This is a long shot, but do you know what animal Pakal was afraid of?
You're asking the wrong amnesiac.
Do you know anything about the theft of Prudence Rutherford's necklace?
I can't remember.
You rest up. I'll be back.
Be careful.
Any news?
Alejandro says you're unethical, a modern-day conquistador. That you're robbing Mexico of its cultural history.
And I say Alejandro is the real bully of the playground, a lunch money extortionist who loves nothing more than to see the other boys and girls go hungry.
Do you, by any chance, know what animal Pakal was afraid of?
You've got me there.
I'd better get going.
Bye now.
Need something?
Apparently, a Topeka woman named Prudence Rutherford has recently been visited by a red-handed thief, too. Do you have any idea how I might get in touch with her?
Afraid I can't help you there.
Do you, by any chance, know what animal Pakal was afraid of?
Afraid I can't help you there.
I've got work to do.
Bye!
You have no voicemail.
Boswell, Jackson, and Rose, how may I direct your call?
This is Nancy Drew, calling for Franklin Rose, please.
Just a minute, please.
Nancy, to what do I owe the pleasure of this call?
I need to contact a woman named Prudence Rutherford. I noticed she's on the board of the Topeka Commission for the Arts, and that they've donated money to Beech Hill. Any idea how I might track her down?
Well, you're in luck. It so happens that Prudence and I sat on the panel of judges for the Kansas Speak No Evil Mime competition for 3 years in a row, back when I lived in Wichita. How's that for a small world?
You judged a mime competition?
Indeed I did. I haven't talked to Prudence in about 10 years. But let's see if I still have her in this old dinosaur of a Rolodex. Ah, yes, here we go. Got a pen? It's area code 785-555-7279.
What's this all about?
I think Ms. Rutherford had a run-in with a red-handed thief, much like the one who took the pecan carving.
Ha! You're a real pro, Nancy. Say, why don't I call ahead and let Prudence know what's going on? That way I can say hello, and she'll be expecting you.
That would be great, Mr. Rose.
Not a problem, dear.
Yes, hello.
Hi, this is Nancy Drew calling from Washington, D.C. I'm trying to reach Prudence Rutherford, please.
Oh, yes. Franklin told me you'd be calling. Such dreadful news about Beech Hill. I will do everything in my power to help you catch those rapscallions. To think how they violated the sanctity of my domicile. Good heavens.
I'm sorry to hear about your loss. What can you tell me about the necklace?
I can't even think about it. Oh, just the very thought of my precious necklace gone, stranded, orphaned, and in the hands of some dirty stranger makes my blood boil.
Was the necklace a gift?
I inherited it from my mother-in-law. But you see, the necklace means much more to me than just a handful of priceless rubies.
More? In what way?
I had the necklace restrung to include an exquisite jade carving as the centerpiece, a genuine artifact of the ancient Maya. The carving is not only one of a kind, but a Rutherford family heirloom given to me by my great-grandfather when I was just a little girl.
Does the carving have any meaning that you know of?
It features a rare glyph. No one's been able to give me a precise translation. But most epigraphers have agreed that it has something to do with a snake, the color green, and the direction south. It's terribly fascinating.
Do you think the thief or thieves had any idea of what they were stealing?
Oh, they must have known. The rest of my valuables were left untouched. Frankly, I don't know whether to be grateful or insulted.
What about evidence?
The first thing I saw when I opened my eyes was this positively ghoulish red handprint on the wall. I nearly jumped out of my skin.
A red handprint was left at the scene of the crime at Beech Hill, too. Ms. Rutherford, I'm almost certain that these robberies were committed by the same person.
But why? What is so special about these carvings?
Ms. Rutherford, it would be so helpful if I knew exactly what your carving looked like. Could you send me a picture that shows it in detail?
I can do better than a photo. The insurance company made this dreadful replica of the necklace with the idea that I would wear such a thing to public functions. Please! But I could send that to you if you'd like.
Oh, that would be wonderful. How soon could you have it here?
You'll have it tomorrow or the next day. My secretary will have the address of the museum. Now, if that is all you require, young lady, I will need to attend to other pressing matters.
Thanks a million, Miss Rutherford. I won't let you down.
Call me Prudence. Oh, and Nancy, when you find the villains who did this to me, do me a favor and give them a sound thrashing.
I sure will. Goodbye. Looks like I need to find someone who speaks Nahuatl.
Hello, Nancy.
I need to know the Nahuatl word for snake. Can you help me?
What do you need that word for?
I'd rather not say. It's part of my investigation.
Now, if only I could remember the word for snake. I hear you have been a great help to Henrik. I wonder if you can help me improve my memory, too.
What are you talking about, Alejandro?
I am almost certain that the provenance documents for the Pakal carving were falsified. I have asked Joanna to see the documents, but she evades me. If you can find that file in her office and bring it to me, I think it might help my memory of Nahuatl a lot.
What makes you think they were falsified?
In Mexico, it is common knowledge that the carving was stolen from Pakal's tomb when it was first excavated. But no one has been able to prove it. If I can determine that the provenance documents are a fraud, this will be the first major step toward legal repatriation of the artwork, whenever and wherever it resurfaces.
Okay, Alejandro. I'll see what I can do.
I feel my Nahuatl coming back to me already. Do you know what Cihuapili means? Princess or lady. Now, if only I could remember the word for snake.
I should get back to the museum.
Goodbye.
Nancy, you have brought me back to my work.
What have you remembered?
I've been working like a fiend. Look at the board. This has something to do with the plot at the museum, Nancy. I'm sure of it.
What is the Prison of Stone?
It's a tomb. Pakal called it a prison because it was designed to prevent the Whisperer's soul from entering the underworld.
That's kind of creepy.
The Whisperer came from a distinguished line of royal scribes. I can't seem to remember her name. But I do recall that she wrote an account of Maya history that greatly angered Pakal because of the way it depicted his ascent to the throne.
How did Pakal wish to be depicted?
From the age of 12, when he came to the throne, Pakal claimed to be divinely appointed the first true authentic king of the Maya. Then, the Whisperer came along and wrote that Pakal was only king because his mother pulled some strings. It was quite a blow to Pakal's image.
So he put her in a stone prison?
Pakal swore that the Whisperer's words would never see the light of day. He put her body, her soul, and her writings all in a tomb and locked it up tight.
Wait, Henrik, a prison of stone? We're not talking about the monolith, are we?
That's the idea.
Does anyone else know about this?
Good question. I'm certain that there's a dirty rat trying to get into that tomb. This is where my memory fizzles out. If I could only figure out why I took the Pakal.
Do you think there is anyone I can trust?
Please don't breathe a word of this. There's too much at stake.
I don't suppose you have a Nahuatl word for snake floating around in your memory bank somewhere, do you?
Who knows?
Have you ever been part of a smuggling racket?
I don't know.
You rest up. I'll be back.
Be careful.
Disc.
Hello? We're sorry. Your call cannot be... We're sorry. Your call...
Daddle residence.
Hi, may I speak to Henry Daddle, please?
Speaking.
Mr. Daddle, my name is Nancy Drew. This is a long shot, but I'm calling regarding a Maya artifact that was bought at auction in 1898 by one Henry Albert Daddle. Does that ring any bells?
Sure. Henry Albert Daddle Sr. was my great-grandfather. You're talking about the jade carving, right?
Yes, exactly. Wow, I can't believe my luck.
Well, it's a lucky life if you ask me. So what can I do for you?
I'm wondering if the artifact is still in the family.
Forgive me, Miss Drew. Who are you exactly?
I'm a detective investigating the recent theft of another Maya jade carving at Beech Hill.
I see. Well, I was the last to inherit the carving, but my daughter Penelope was so intrigued with it that I gave it to her. I'm sure she'd be happy to talk to you about it. Why don't you give her a call on her line? It's 555-3197.
Will do. Thanks, Mr. Daddle.
My pleasure.
Hello?
Hi, is this Penelope?
Not even.
Oh, is this 605-555-3197?
Yeah, but no one calls me Penelope anymore. Except my parents, that is. To my friends, the art world, and anyone else who made it out of the 20th century, I'm Poppy.
The art world? Wait, you're not Poppy Dada, are you?
Ta-da! Ping, ping! You win! Who's this?
My name's Nancy Drew. I'm a detective.
A detective? No way. So do you get to wear a sassy tweed hat and pick hairs off dead bodies and gross, creepy stuff like that?
Actually, I try to keep a low profile, and the tweed hat, well, it's a little conspicuous.
So, where'd you get my name? Don't tell me I'm, like, wanted by the FBI or something. That would be too scandalous.
Not quite. Taylor Sinclair told me about you. I saw one of your paintings in his office, here in Washington, D.C.
So, how do you know Big Bunny Sinclair?
Oh, it's a small world, you know.
Are you kidding? Try finding yourself in line at the grocery store with your dad, your driver's ed teacher, and your creepy lab partner from last semester all at the same time. Vermilion is like some kind of petri dish for close encounters of the small world. But anyway, has Taylor been pushing those Oaxacan cookies on you? You haven't eaten one, have you?
Why, are they poisonous?
Let's put it this way. His trip to Oaxaca was about 2 years ago, and he's been trying to move those rancid lard biscuits ever since.
Thanks for the tip, Poppy. I can see you're going to be a detective's best friend.
That's hot. What's the case? Are there dead bodies involved? Do you need to, like, tap my phone or impersonate me or something?
Before I get into that, tell me about the artwork you do. It looks very interesting.
It's a new form I made up myself. I approach each piece as a synesthetic, interactive, organic journey.
I'm afraid I'm a little rusty on my art terms. What do you mean?
Have you heard the saying that a work of art is never finished, just abandoned? Well, I'm taking that idea to the limit by making art that will keep changing as different people encounter, perceive, and interact with it. I'm tired of artwork that says, "Don't touch." I'm all about letting go, about sending my work into the world and seeing how it continues to become.
It sounds awfully hip.
Ugh, don't get me started on art. Now, what's your name again? Oh, yeah, Nancy. Let's have the dish. Who are you after? The Chinese mafia?
No mafia that I know of.
African elephant poachers?
No, no elephants involved.
South American drug lords?
Not this time.
A sinister counterfeiting ring right here in Vermilion? Am I even getting warm?
There was a robbery at Beach Hill, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. This thief is after something big, and I've got to figure out what it is.
Drama. So, where do the daddles come in?
I'm trying to track down certain Maya jade carvings that haven't fallen into the thief's hands yet. I think one of them might be in your family.
You mean that ancient green rock with the weird symbol on it? I slapped some shoe polish on it and stuck it in one of my paintings.
Poppy, what were you thinking? You'll never get it back.
That's the whole point. Don't you see? It's an organic process. I mean, how can people really relate to art if it doesn't come to life and grow and die just like they do? That carving is part of something bigger now.
It seems awfully reckless to me, not to mention the wrench it throws into my investigation.
Oh, Nancy, don't be such a prude. Taylor's probably still got the artwork. At least, I don't think he sold it yet. Why don't you ask him? Tell him you want to see the piece called Deadly Midnight Snack. It's the one with the rubber shark.
The one with the rubber shark. Yes, I've seen it, but I didn't notice any jade carving.
Well, take a closer look there, sweets. It's in there. If you really need the carving to crack this case, why don't you just go ahead and take it?
But wouldn't it ruin your painting?
Of course not. After all, this is a chance to enact exactly what I've been talking about, the organic process, inviting my viewers to interact with my work. The deal is, you can take the carving, but you have to put something in its place.
I can choose anything? A light bulb? A magnifying glass? A pair of headphones?
No, it should be something more organic. Stay with the title, Deadly Midnight Snack. And don't be afraid to go way out. As an artist, I can tell you that inspiration bites in the most mysterious ways.
I'll do my best.
Right on. But let's keep Taylor out of this. He'd probably blow a gasket if he saw you tampering with the merchandise. That's all art is to him, you know. Merchandise.
It's a deal.
Good luck, Nancy.
Thanks, Poppy. Bye.
Any news?
Mind if I help myself to one of those scrumptious-looking Oaxacan cookies?
Be my guest.
May I take a closer look at that wacky Dada painting?
Be my guest. I just had a call from Poppy this morning. She says she's in a really creative period right now. I said, please, sweetie, if you get any more creative, they're going to lock you up.
Pardon me a moment, Nancy. I'll be right back, I hope.
Need something?
I need to know the Nahuatl word for snake. Any ideas?
Afraid I can't help you there.
I've got work to do.
See you around.
Good afternoon, young lady.
According to your notes, Pakal made a 6-part key to the Whisperer's tomb and scattered the pieces around the world. Do you remember anything about this?
6 keys? 6 keys? 6 keys! Nancy, what are the 4 corners of the world? North, south, east, and west. Plus the first king, Pakal himself, and the Copan fool. When they're all assembled, they open the tomb. Don't you see? This is why I stole the Pakal, to prevent some other schemer from putting the key together.
Maybe I'd better tell Joanna what's going on.
You must keep this to yourself for now. It's your only hope of getting to the bottom of this.
Henrik, I need to know where you put the Pakal carving.
You're asking the wrong amnesiac.
You rest up. I'll be back.
I'll do my best.
Keep it real. Max speaking.
Hi, do you sell a compound of mercury and sulfur?
Mercuric sulfide? Oh, we sure do. How much do you need? First things first. What account's this for?
Well, the account number is BH008P, but I'm not sure if we need any.
Well, hello there, Beach Hill. Hey, you're not Sunny June. Whatever happened to that guy? I suppose he caught a ride on a flying saucer, eh? What a riot. I'm sorry. Anyway, you don't need to reorder, do you? Unless you ate last week's shipment for breakfast, that is.
Was the package shipped to the museum?
Oops, I guess we didn't ship it at all. It looks like the package was picked up here at the warehouse.
Can you remember anything about the person who picked up the package?
I sure can't. Guess I must have been at lunch or something.
So there hasn't been a holdup at the distributor or anything like that?
Holdup? Oh, I don't know where you heard that. We've got enough mercuric sulfide in-house to sink a ship.
Do you know who placed that order?
The initials on the order are JR.
You're sure it was last week?
Oh, that's what it says here.
Well, thanks for your help.
Sure thing. I hope there wasn't any problem with the stuff, was there? We only used the top-grade mercuric sulfide.
Judging by the impression it left, I'd have to agree that the quality was fine.
Well, you sound a little green in the chemicals department, if you don't mind my saying so. I hope you know that mercuric sulfide is highly toxic. Makes you crazy.
Toxic?
Looks like I've got another call coming in here. You give us a call in about 4 months or so when you start to run out, okie doke? And don't forget to keep it real.
Hello.
Do you know what cinnabar is?
The red powder that the Maya used? Sure, I know it. They use it at Beach Hill too, do they not?
They do use it at the museum, but Joanna told me they haven't been able to get any in a while.
What is your point?
I think Joanna may have been less than truthful with me.
Have you called the police?
I don't want to jump to conclusions.
Of course. Sister Joanna couldn't possibly be a thief now, could she?
I should get back to the museum.
Adios, Nancy.
Chaco Canyon Cultural Center.
Hi, I'm hoping to speak to someone about the theft that happened there recently.
Are you the press?
No, I'm a detective investigating a similar crime in Washington, D.C.
This is Sheila Schultz, the director. What would you like to know?
My name is Nancy Drew. I'm calling from the Beech Hill Museum in Washington, D.C. I understand you had some rare Maya artifacts stolen recently.
That's right. It's a terrible loss. And the police here have no leads.
Beech Hill was robbed, too. We lost one of our prized jade carvings.
I'm very sorry to hear that.
I'm wondering if the robberies are connected. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions about the incident at Chaco Canyon?
Fire away.
What types of artifacts did the thief get away with?
Only the center's most prized pieces. The case contained 5 pre-Columbian artifacts that were excavated right from this area.
Do you have a list of the stolen pieces?
I know those pieces like the back of my hand. There were 3 pottery pieces, a small stone figurine with a snake head, and an ornamental jade carving.
I'm interested in the jade carving. What did it look like?
It was highly unusual. There was a glyph on it that no one could translate. Until we hired Henrik Vanderhoen, that is. His opinion was that it's Mayan in origin, and that it may have been a place name glyph for this area. As you can imagine, we regarded it as something of a regional treasure.
Could you send me a photo of that jade carving so I can take a look at the glyph?
I'm afraid I sent our only print off to the insurance company. They said they'd return it, but who knows when our claim will be processed. I'm sorry.
I've just got to get my hands on a replica of that jade carving you lost. Do you have any ideas?
Not off the top of my head, but maybe one of my staff will have a bright idea. I need some time to ask around. Can you call back later?
Sure thing.
Feel free to call if you have any more questions.
You have voicemail. Press 0 to retrieve.
Nancy, it's Joanna. The police are done giving me the third degree, but now the board has suspended me. To make a long story short, I'm forbidden to set foot in the museum. Could you please call Franklin Rose and try to reason with him? If we don't get a move on, this exhibit is going straight down the tubes.
To reply, you have no... You have... You have... You have...
Boswell, Jackson, and Rose, how may I direct your call?
This is Nancy Drew, calling for Franklin Rose, please.
Just a minute, please.
Nancy, you must be psychic. I was just getting ready to call you myself.
Oh, really? Why?
I feel I should apologize for the situation that's going on at the museum, dear. I really did think we were setting you up with a nice little internship, a breather from your casework, but instead it looks like we've fed you to the lions.
Well, in all my travels, I still haven't found a mystery free zone, Mr. Rose.
Speaking of travel, I got a postcard from your father in Ouagadougou. Apparently, Burkina Faso has become the cultural darling of West Africa. He must be having quite an adventure.
Like father, like daughter. Anyway, Mr. Rose, I'm calling about Joanna.
I think I know what you're going to say, Nancy. Let me be frank. Joanna Riggs has been in the doghouse with the board for months. Her thirst for acclaim has led her to gamble the future and the reputation of Beech Hill time and again. Now that we've lost the Pakal carving, one of our most notable pieces, well, she's just got to be stopped.
I know you're upset, but the Pakal theft is not what it seems.
It's not your job to defend her, Nancy. Even if she didn't steal the Pakal herself, how is it that she let this crime happen right under her nose? Did she want the insurance money? Is she mixed up with the black market? Something is rotten in the state of Denmark. That's Shakespeare.
I have reason to believe that there's another explanation.
Look, I've got a client waiting, Nancy. What we need now is for you to take up the slack. I've spoken to the rest of the board, and we've agreed that the best thing is to put you in charge.
But, Mr. Rose, I don't think Joanna is responsible for the Bacall theft. She shouldn't be punished.
She's not being punished, dear. In legal terms, we're suspending her in abundance of caution, so she won't do any more damage to Beach Hill's reputation or her own. We're counting on you to catch this thief red-handed. Ha ha! Just kidding, kiddo. If you can get the Bacall back, we'll see about giving Ms. Riggs another chance. That seems fair, doesn't it?
It's a deal, Mr. Rose.
Bye, kiddo.
Hello, Nancy. You have a special delivery for me, I hope?
Here's your file, as requested.
Good work, my friend. I suppose you would like something in return?
A deal's a deal.
The Nahuatl word for snake is coatl. C-O-A-T-L.
I should get back to the museum.
Adios, Nancy. Hello.
Have you heard? The police received an anonymous tip, and they're considering Joanna a prime suspect in the Bacall theft. They've taken her in for questioning.
I called in that tip. She lied about the cinnabar, and you may not know this, but she has jeopardized the museum's finances with all of her wheeling and dealing. Why should she not be questioned?
I should get back to the museum.
Yes, you should.
Good afternoon, young lady.
One of the pieces that was stolen from the Chaco Canyon Cultural Center was a jade carving with an unusual glyph on it. Do you remember translating it?
I can't remember.
Did you use Joanna's name last week to place an order for cinnabar with Keep It Real Restoration?
You're asking the wrong amnesiac.
Do you have anything against Joanna?
Who knows?
You rest up. I'll be back.
I'll do my best.
It's locked. It's locked. Went out.
Transmítelo ahora.
título ahora. Mensaje recibido. Entregaremos el paquete lo más pronto posible. Cambio y fuera.
Chaco Canyon Cultural Center.
Hi, this is Nancy Drew calling.
Hi, Nancy. It's Sheila. Well, we racked our brains. Finally, one of my staff came up with the original box that the carving was packed in. The piece was encased in a tight foam cast to prevent damage during shipping. I'm not sure how much good it'll do you, but I can send it to you if you like.
That just might work.
Henrik left Beech Hill as his forwarding address, so I know what to do. I'll send it express.
Thanks a million, Sheila.
Good luck with your investigation.
Good afternoon, young lady.
Henrik, I received a note from your friends in Copan. I've got the Copan Fool Key. I still need the Pakal, though. How's your memory?
The tomb. Nancy, I hid the Pakal carving in the replica of the Pakal tomb at the bottom of the temple exhibit. Huh. Now, how did I think of that? And another thing, you'll need to get past that computer quiz. Sunny set it up with an impossible question. No one knows what Pakal was afraid of. But Sunny was petrified of the Coatimundi. It's an ornery bandit with a narrow snout and a long ringed tail, much like a raccoon or a polecat.
You rest up. I'll be back.
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
I bet I can make a mold from this foam core.
You have no voicemail.
Boswell, Jackson, and Rose.
May I speak to Franklin Rose, please?
Who may I say is calling?
This is Nancy Drew.
Just a minute, please.
Nancy, how's your investigation coming along?
I'm making good progress, and the Pakal carving is safe and sound. But I'm afraid I can't tell you everything yet.
What in the world are you talking about?
I'm sorry, but I can't explain everything now. I'll take good care of the carving, I promise.
What can I say, Nancy? I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. Do what you have to do, but let's get this mess cleaned up, all right?
So you'll call Joanna and invite her back to work?
I'll call her right away.
Thanks, Mr. Rose.
That's what I'm here for.
Thanks for clearing my name, Nancy. Honestly, I mean, what kind of moron would I be to try and ruin my own exhibit? Anyway, we need to make up for lost time. I need you to go to the storeroom and start unpacking some of those crates. One of the pieces has a fancy security device on it. The code is 0677.
I've got work to do.
Semper ubi sabubi.
According to Henrik's notes, I need to make a key out of these pieces. Now I have the key! It's locked. Wow, these are heavy. I'm not sure I can hold on to these stones for very much longer. I've got to put these things down. Looks like this side is missing a part. The poem said, "When the first king ascends again." This side looks damaged. I'll have to choose which side of the cube goes here. Nothing happened. Thank you. This should be the last step. I wonder what's inside. It's blank.
Who's your friend, Nancy?
Boo!
Taylor Sinclair!
Who'd you expect, the Tooth Fairy? Looks like someone forgot her beauty cream. I guess we can't all age gracefully.
I'm sure she would say the same about you.
You've been a top-notch assistant, Nancy, but I'm afraid you're just not going to make it in the art world.
Why are you doing this?
Nancy, do you have any idea what that book contains?
Help me out, Sinclair. I'm drawing a blank.
The Whisperer's writings are the only known personal account of Maya life, the only written glimpse into Bacall's time anywhere. Do you know what I can get for that thing on the black market?
You have no right to do this. The book is not yours to sell.
Simple economics suggest otherwise. And I am the art dealer.
This tomb and all of its contents belong to Mexico.
Finders keepers, I say. Nobody even realizes this thing has any contents. Won't they get a surprise when they finally open it up and find that it contains a 7th century scribe and a 21st century detective? Adios, Nancy.
It's too dark in here. I need a light. I'm starting to run out of air in here.
Behold! Our heroine emerges from the tomb, like a mermaid from the sea.
Meanwhile, the foolish villain stews in the sour soup of his own miscalculation.
From deep in the recesses of time, a wise royal scribe whispers her thanks.
And a priceless chapter of history is rescued from obscurity. Way to go, Nancy!
What in the world?
Confound you, Nancy Drew!
Dear Dad, it was great to talk to you on the phone last night. I can't wait to see you back in River Heights where I can fill you in on the whole story. Can you believe that your own daughter was recently standing face to face with a real mummy? Now that the scribe's book has been recovered, I understand how important it is and why Taylor thought he could make a fortune selling it on the black market. The book contains one of the only personal accounts of Maya life in existence anywhere. I'm sure it'll be a tremendous addition to our knowledge of the Maya, once it's translated, that is. And now that Henrik's memory is back up to speed again, I'm sure he'll be itching to get to work on it. Taylor Sinclair won't be making any art deals for a long time, though, that's for sure. I guess I shouldn't be surprised about Alejandro's discovery that the Bacall carving's provenance documents were faked after all. When Franklin Rose and the board found out, they arranged to return the artifact to Mexico right away. Mexican officials are so happy to have the artifact back, they have pledged a new era of diplomatic relations with Beach Hill. Joanna sure learned her lesson about making deals with shady operators like Taylor. The board has agreed to give her another chance, as long as she reforms her business tactics. And what else? Oh yes, Poppy Dada's announced a new direction in her artwork. All her new paintings are going to feature, what else, mysterious red handprints. So I guess everyone is taking off in new directions now. I'm going to stay and help this exhibit get launched. But I'll see you back at home in a couple of weeks. Have a safe trip home. Love, Nancy.
Dear Nancy, Bess and George told me you're on a case in D.C. I hope everything is working out for you. I wish I could say the same for me. I'm planning on living here, but there's been some trouble. I think someone or something doesn't want me here. Please, Nancy, I'm afraid I can't stay here very much longer. I know you're busy, but I'm desperate. I need you to come out and investigate. Please say you will. Your friend, Sally.